Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUVU Gaming, and today we are back in Founders Fortune, and we are gonna start a brand new game because the profession update is here, which completely changes the job system so that now you can actually prioritize jobs, so you can have up to 3 different priorities for jobs for each of your colonists. And they also have a whole bunch of new skills that you can unlock. So you can see here, you can grow trees, you can do martial arts, you can do sneaking. There's a whole bunch of other things that we can do. They also added doors to the game. Now there are new fortifications. They added sheep to the game. There's sheep on the map. We can't tame them yet, but apparently that is intended for later. So just a whole bunch of new changes, and I thought it's probably a good idea to just start over right now. We weren't really that far. Save files are compatible, but if you are playing a current game right now and you keep playing it, all your colonists are gonna have their skills reset to zero. So if you have anyone who has like high skills, they're gonna lose them right now, or high, you know, experience in their jobs. So yeah, anyway, let's just jump into this and see if we can figure things out. I'm still like completely noob at this, so yeah, I'm probably gonna mess this up. Okay, so we have hate winter, bad health. Ooh, that one might not be so good. Treatments are 20% more likely to fail, and then favorite food, pumpkin stew. But you are a forester, and apparently you have a planting trees skill, which would probably be really nice. They also added that you can plant things like apple trees and pine trees and stuff. So that might be really handy to, for instance, plant our own for apple trees. Then we have soldier, medium armor, and wooden swords. Ooh, that's not actually so bad, but she does have the bad health, which I'm not so happy about. But let's see, what about you? Favorite food, apple strudel. Insomnia. Has trouble sleeping and doesn't rest as well as others. Takes double the time to fully rest compared to others. That's probably not so good. You are an optimist though, and you're a farmer. But I'm kind of thinking I would like to see if I can get someone a little bit better. Hates winter, loves summer. But that's another soldier. If we keep her, then we definitely want a guy, right? Because we're going to want to ensure that maybe we can get some kids. Xenophobe, dumb, and killer. You do have some nice skills otherwise, but let's see. Of course, we can remove these, but they might really stall your progress in the beginning, I'm thinking. So, sometimes she'll just continue eating even though she's already full. It's not the worst thing, but we don't have a lot of food in the beginning. Soldier, medium armor. No, I like someone with some different... Okay, this is actually fine. Nothing bad here, but then you have no professional skills. Let's see. Farmer, master outfit, doctor flu treatment, overeater. Love spring. You're not too bad either. Optimist, insomnia, good health, overeater, hates fall. Allergic to potatoes. I would prefer not to have anyone with allergies, because you might end up only having one type of food for a while in the beginning, and then you might end up having them being sick all the time, right? Allergic to apples, dumb, survivalist, love summer. Pessimist, allergic to potatoes, and dumb, but he has a lot of other skills. So it's really hard to know what you would want to focus on, right? I would have liked someone with... Oh, insomnia and bad health. Don't like that. good health and survivalist, but you're a girl. Eberhard Bach, bad health, survivalist, love swing, diplomat, optimist. It seems to alternate. So between girl and boy when you do this. Love summer, hate fall, xenophile, first of planting trees. But you already have that yourself. But you do have the bad health, which I don't like. We might keep him and see if we can get someone better for you. Allergic to tomatoes. Miner, mining iron, craftsman, forging. Not the worst. Doctor applying splints, favorite fruit salad, and a diplomat. Because of her charismatic nature. She is quick to make friends and smooth over past quarrels. When she socializes with members of other factions, there's a small chance to increase diplomatic relationships. It's not the most amazing, though. And no professional skills. This could also be something if you have good things up here, of course. Let's see. Farmer, but you're limping and a xenophobe. I don't know what the outfits, how much they matter at all. Bad health, overeater, limping, xenophile. Oh, it's so hard to figure out who you want. Oh boy. Allergic to apples, allergic to tomatoes, diplomat, experienced in battle. An overeater though, but already has much experience on the battlefield and is not scared of easily, does not receive mood penalties for pain and death around her. You know what, we're just gonna go with these because I can do this forever and I'm not really exactly sure who I should prioritize. I'm thinking I would like a farmer actually, or someone with farming skills, but then you end up getting someone who's really bad at other things or has really bad personality traits, and then you have to struggle with that until you can remove them, right? So we're just gonna jump in and try and see if we can figure things out, right? So we had one little village here, one there, this one there, that's three. Okay, it looks like we only have three on this, and there's only one of them that is a little bit big. We don't technically have to do anything down here. Let's see what we have access to, because we want apples, I think. We do have iron. We do have some apple trees over here. We can cut down the trees, technically. I don't think you can remove this. That's the sheep that are new. Also have apple trees over here. I could kind of just make them go over there and build over there, right? Oh, we had one there as well. Okay, maybe we actually have four one here. Do like the mini apple trees though. What do we have here? We have iron, iron, iron. But I don't know, I don't think you can remove that from the map. I actually don't know if you can. Like, what can you actually remove if you want to build? Can you build anywhere? I don't actually know. Like, this is gonna block us a bit, I think, from building. I don't feel like this is a good place to start. We do have crystals, we do have cotton, we have healing plants. But I think we would like to get some, but then here, it's hard to get crystals. Maybe we should just stick with where we are and see if we can make do with that. We do have the apples over here, so yeah. Okay, let's see. We need a bonfire. That is one thing we need. So we have you there. Where are we gonna want to actually build something? Oh, we could remove some of the trees. Now we can grow trees, so we can actually grow our own little forest, I guess. But if we want room for houses and stuff. You know what? I think we're just gonna put it right there. It is a learning process, and we're definitely gonna want to have these, right, and this one, so that we can get new people, we have a place where they can get food, and they can sleep, right? Is there anything else we need right now? The next thing we are gonna want is this, right? Okay, that's the new mines, right? They also added new mines, but as you can see, they're pretty expensive. 600 wood, 20 iron ore, 700 coins, 500, 600 coins. So this is definitely some later game stuff. It's not something you have access to right off the bat. I just wanted to remind myself if there was anything. We're definitely gonna need some storage fairly soon. at 40 left. I'm kind of thinking I should get this, but we need a bit more cotton for that. Because we're going to need stone fairly soon, if I remember, for the, was it a campfire or something? Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's take a look before we kind of kick things off here. You had the first skill, right? So definitely going to want you to do something like that. We're going to need someone to do some farming as well. And doctor is probably a really good idea to have that as a high priority, right? So you, yeah, that's probably fine. What else do we need? We don't need a farmer right off the bat. We do need someone to do some mining, though. So I'm kind of thinking if I set you to be a scholar, right? Then you should go and mine some crystals. So we can get farming unlocked, because that is like a really high priority. And then you are going to collect some wood, which is the first thing we're going to need. Yeah. Yeah. Let's do that. But right now, I think, what was it I needed? The two cotton for. Oh, that was storage, I think, wasn't it? Yeah, we needed two cotton. So, let's see if I can remember who's who here. That is the problem. Keeping track of the name. So, Ude is the forester. Yes. Ude, I want you to go and collect a little bit of cotton before anything else. Just so we have that. There we go. Okay. And then, Griselda should just start building something. Yeah. Very nice. Okay, wish fulfilled. Uh-huh, because we got the campfire, or the bonfire. And now they got the basket. Reach level 3 as a forester. Okay, that makes sense. That's his skill, so he wants to do that. We need the research book stand, but for that we're going to need a house. Why did we get a little... Expects a better home. Owns a sleeping spot. Yeah. So you are going to take ownership of that, and Ude is going to take ownership of this. There we go. That should make them happy about that at least. We need a healing potion cabinet in the colony, but that has to go inside. So let's look at this. We are going to need a house of some kind. Just thinking. Because I don't know if you can. Can you? No, see, you can't do that. So, but we could build a house here and then kind of clear out these trees here, maybe. And then kind of build the town out this way. It's probably not the best place to actually be building here because there's so many things blocking us. But. See. Yeah, I think we're gonna do that. We're gonna try and build something down here. So you can build a path. So that's like this. I want the path to be kind of over here, I think, actually. So if we put the house here. Kind of want a decent size. Like this. And actually, how do we remove them again once they're built? Well, maybe you have to do it like this. And then you can remove them and then you make them again. I don't actually quite know. But we're going to need some walls as well. So let's see, we have 28. Let's put this here. There we go, we still have enough wood. And let's fill in most of this. I want to see how much I need for a door. Simple wooden door, we need 10. Okay, so we should have enough. We should have enough if we close this. Right, and then we're going to put the door in here. It needs to be built on a wall, yeah. Right there. Yep. Okay. So for these ones, I know I got a question about this on one of the videos. If we actually had to put them inside, and I don't know exactly what they do, but I think it does matter if you put them inside, because you can see sleeping spot is in room no, and then you have like bedroom beauty, house beauty, and the owner. So I think it really matters to them if they are inside. It would matter to you as well, wouldn't it, that you could sleep inside instead of outside in the rain. Oh, there we go. We got a migrant. So let's just actually take you. And I want to know what the traits are. Well, don't technically, right now we just need more people, but eventually you would probably want to sometimes reject them. I'm a level 2 soldier. Okay, that's not too bad. Let's accept you. Okay, so we got Andreas. Okay, you're gonna help with building. Where did my... Oh, Udi is still running around. Okay, well, you got into cutting down some trees, so that's good. So I think, because I'm pretty sure we're gonna need this fairly soon. Well, for one, we need this 15 wood. Definitely want to get that built. So let's see, we can always move it. Just wanna get it started as soon as possible. Then we can take these. And let's put you there. Let's put you there for now. We're gonna need another one. How much cotton do I have? I don't have any. Okay, Ude. Ude, Ude, Ude. Can you just gather a little bit more cotton, please? Okay, so need to select research. Yep. We want farming, for sure. So, yes, Griselda is... No? Okay, she went to sleep. Well, we kind of need to get this constructed ASAP, right? So let's do that. And let's take a look at everybody's work here. So we had a doctor. Oh, yes. So Griselda is our scholar. She should start focusing on that now. And then I should probably have gotten some crystals. But she's just been too busy. I'm kind of hoping eventually they're gonna add a building as a job. So you can prioritize that someone focuses on that. Instead of... Because they right now they prioritize building over everything else. So if you have a farmer, you would want him to focus on getting your food, right? And not spending all his time building. And the same for her. I would rather have had her actually go and get some crystals, for instance. So I'm kind of thinking it would be nice if we had that option. Can't build you yet. Okay, let's just speed this up. Let them get a little bit of rest. Here we go. Oh, you just needed a midnight snack. Oh boy. Come on, guys. There we go. I think we're getting ready. So hopefully, see, because now she's probably gonna go and help with building. Which is not really what I would like her to do. I want her to go and cut some crystals or get some crystals. Well, she's hungry. Was she the one who had overeating? Yeah, she's an overeater. Oh boy, okay, we're gonna go and tell you to gather some crystals. So, because otherwise she's just gonna stand there and eat all our food, right? We have 13 apples, 11 tomatoes, and 8 potatoes. Definitely, definitely need to get that farming going. So, let's get the crystals, and as soon as she has 5 crystals, she should go and do... Oh, and we actually need to finish this, I think. Well, she should be able to use it already. It's been built. Yeah. Okay, so you... Oh, you remembered. So it seems like he actually remembers what you tell... That I told him to do this, even though his job is to do this. So that's something to keep an eye on. Okay, well, there is tons of stuff to figure out all the time. So I actually wondered, what was it, this stone stockpile, and we do have the stone right over here. I'm kind of thinking, let's put it here on the back of the house, just like this, and then you don't actually need to do any more of that. But I am thinking that let's get you to go and gather some apples right now, just to get a little bit of food coming in. Yes, we have 18 cotton, so we are good. We can make another one of these. Let's put you right there for now. Analyze crystals on the book stand, yes. Okay, so let's see. You are getting... Yeah, we need 5 crystals. You are getting us some apples. Okay, let's speed this up a little bit. I just don't want it to kind of get away from me. A colonist has worked too much under terrible conditions. Oh boy. Okay, that's Andreas. So for 12 minutes, if you don't keep your colonists happy, they'll start being defiant and might stop following your orders. That's not good. Sleeping bag. Okay, this one I think doesn't have... No. Oh, that's the one we still have to build. Can I get you to do that? No, I can't actually get you to do anything for 12 minutes. I hate it here. I don't want to work anymore. That's not good. Okay, so let's see. What do you have? You want a sleeping spot? Well, I can't really do that yet. Well, I can if I... Oh, I guess they had a little chat. Griselda, you shouldn't do that. Oh, you go over there to relax. Okay, let's get her to construct this. Because we have enough crystals. I was worried she was going to get more crystals, but she shouldn't. Because we're full. So she should do this soon. But right now, I just want the sleeping spot for Andreas. To make him happier. Improve relations with enduring people to minus 20%. Okay. Andreas. Here we go. You. Oh. Oh, I can't even assign a sleeping spot for him. Okay. They can take ownership there, but I can't actually do anything. Oh, well, I think that you should be able to do something like that. It's a little silly that you can't, like, fulfill him his... One thing that you can't tell him to go and work, right? But he should still, you should be able to give him something like that. Okay, so, reach relationship buddy with Griselda. And he wants to level up. Griselda wants a healing potion cabinet. Oh, we are actually full on wood. Let's see, stretch. Healing potion cabinet. Let's put one of those over here. And did we? Yes, we did. So we can get some wood.
Yep.
Udi. You. I don't know where you are. We are all the way over there. We're having a little chat, I think. There we go. Impressed. Let's have you go and mine some stone. Oh, she's researching now. We are getting a little late here, so I hope she's going to finish this pretty quickly. Because we need to get some farming going, right? So, Andreas, did I ever get around to looking at your jobs, actually? No. He is a soldier, so that... But that's not even a priority thing. He just levels this up, and then you can use points in it, apparently. I'm not quite sure how you get the points, though. Oh, he's dumb and is not going to gain any experience. That is not good. Well, he is a miner, though, so let's give him that as a high priority. And I think I want him to mine the other things here. He can't really mine iron ore yet because we don't have the stretch for it, but he can go and mine stone. So let's have him do that. And we already have a scholar. That's Griselda, right? We have a forester. We need someone to be a farmer, but they can't really do much yet. What do we have? Tend to fields, cook food, gather cotton, harvest apples. Well, they could do some of that, right? Then we have craftsman, doctor. Griselda was a doctor as well, right? Yes. Okay. Well, we have a lot of stuff for this, so I'm thinking... let's have you do this. Right. Okay, but we do need some more wood. Okay, there we go. We got this fulfilled. So, reach relationship with Griselda. That was Udi. Griselda. Ooh, she wants a chair. So, let's get a chair going. Seating. Some kind of chair. Tree stump stool. Tree stump stool. Wood stump stool. I kind of think I like this one. Let's just have it. No, not there. Maybe in between the beds here, someone can go and sit down when they need to put on their shoes or their socks or whatever. Right, so that is that. And get a sleeping spot. Can I still not? No, it's another 5 minutes before I can do anything about that. Reach relationship. Okay, that was Ude. Mm-hmm. And Griselda wanted to chill, and she wanted to improve relations. You minus 20 points. And that's probably not gonna happen right this minute, right? So let's see. The enduring people. Yeah, so neutral, 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 and we'll attack on sight. Ooh, we can contact them. I don't think we want to do that just yet. Oh, there we go. Now Ude is awake. Yeah. So, let's just have you have a little chat with Griselda. Let's try and get friendly, right? Oh, okay. Griselda is so full of herself, I couldn't stand listening to her. Okay. That didn't quite improve their relationship, but at least she got her wish. So that's good. So satisfaction. Do I have something? Let's just pause here for a second. Do I have something that I want them to? Let's see if we go in here. So dumb. Love summer, right? Where is that one? You don't have any satisfaction yet, but I would love to be able to remove that, right? Then we have Love Summer, Hates Fall, and he's a xenophile. Loves to get to know all kinds of people. But I could technically remove Hates Fall, but... Oh, that's what up here, right? Let's see if we can do that. That's 2 points. Okay, so I can choose to do that. Ude doesn't really care for the colorful leaves and fall, and instead spends her time complaining about the muddy paths and the windy days. So we probably want to remove that, and then, of course, we can add things as well. But you would probably want to remove anything bad first, right? And then we have these options. So let's see, Griselda. You... Oh, you're an overeater. Right. What does that take? That's also 2 points, yes. So once they have 2 points, we definitely have some things we want to remove. There we go. Nice. So, let's go in here. How are we doing on research? 1 out of 5. Wow, that is going so slow. Tables. Let's take this. For now, I think. Yeah. Let's see. Yep, let's put it there. For right now. They're gonna look into making some more houses, I think, as we get a lot of wood and things. We have a little bit of stone. That's the beginning, but... wow, she's sleeping in the middle of the day. Oh, she had a nightmare, a bad conversation, and a bad dream. Man, that is not good. Okay, she's gonna do some more research. She's happy about that. Get a flower pot in her room. Can we do flower pots yet? Decoration. We can. Okay, we're gonna get one of these. Maybe right here would be nice. Yep. Okay, we're still at 1 satisfaction point or rewards. He still wants to be friends with her. Oh, there we go. Now we can take ownership. Nice. Wish fulfilled. He is back to working again. He wants to relax. Yep. Oh, okay, let him just finish that. And then we're going to tell you to... No, let's just tell you to relax a bit. Okay. That should make him happy. Okay, so we are going to continue with this next time, guys. And see how we are going to progress with all of this. But we got pretty far in the first video compared to the previous one, right? Or the previous series, because we know a little bit more about what's going on in Ido. So, This is good. It's a good start. I think we're a little slow on getting into farming, but we should get there fairly soon. So, let me know what you think and what you think about the changes that they have made to the game with this update. And let me know how it's going with your own game if you are playing it yourself. So, thank you for watching. And as always, do take care and happy gaming.